driving along, hauling a trailer, heading to Houston, Texas.
Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. I hope that you're not one of those people who gets car sick because there's a lot of movement behind me, but we, my father and I, we're on our way to Houston, and I'm gonna do my Q&A. I'm gonna do it as best as I can, so bear with me. Kind of excited. I receive questions from a lot of you through text message, private message, comments, different things. So I'm gonna go through some of them and answer as many as I can. Question number one. How have you been keeping yourself together in this new journey God has you in? Very good question. Thank you for thinking that I'm together, number one. I can answer this question very simply, and it's all about trusting God. I constantly have to bring myself back there anytime I feel a little bit of fear creeping in or a little bit of uncertainty. I just have to go back to asking myself, do you really trust God like you say you do? And then I gotta just put it into practice, and that's every day, just trust Him and trust Him. And my life isn't perfect, but it's in God's hands, and I know that His plan is the best one and better than anyone that I could come up with. So that is how I keep my life together. The next question is, what is my fitness routine? Whoa. What is my fitness routine? Okay, so I try and work out Monday through Friday at least 3 times a week. And on the days that I'm not physically in the gym, I focus on the amount of steps that I'm taking. And when I'm in the gym, I'm doing weights, and yeah, and the rest of the time I'm just walking as much as possible. So that's kind of my fitness routine. Very simple, very easy to stick to. If you want to try it, let me know how it goes for you in the comments. Okay, what are my eating habits like? Okay, so I actually have kind of a stringent eating plan as far as time, not as far as the actual contents of my food, but as far as time, I try and stick to eating breakfast at 10. So the first thing I eat for the day is around 10 a.m. And then I prefer around a 5 o'clock or a 6 o'clock dinner. And that kind of gives my body time to digest all the food from the day. And I found that I don't experience bloating when I do that. I don't experience discomfort. I think that that timing is really important. And I eat a little bit of everything, but I try and make sure that I'm fitting vegetables and fruit into my meals every day. And also that I'm not overeating, just, you know, be mindful of portions. You know, don't go crazy. Anytime that I go overboard, I can physically feel it. So yeah, just very simple. Do I have cheat days? Okay, so I have a problem with this whole cheat day mentality, because I feel like if you're cheating, then that means that you're doing something good on certain days and then you're doing something bad on other days. And I feel like if you start categorizing food into good and bad, it's like that whole psychological thing that if I'm not supposed to eat it, you know, you start wanting it more. You don't have to do that. You can still eat all of those foods throughout the week, spread them out, and maybe you don't have them all in one day. Maybe you have them throughout the week, and it's more of a balanced thing.
Moderation.
Moderation, baby. The next one is, what is the biggest personal struggle I'm facing right now? That's a hard one, because I really feel like a lot of my struggles have kind of simmered down. But if I had to say the one thing, and it's not really a struggle, it's more of a question, and the question is, where am I going to live? It's not something I'm stressing about though, because I'm kind of on a timeline to make a decision towards the end of the year. But I just trust in God, and I just trust Him every day, and I ask Him, God, by the way, you know, I'm, you know, still have that question about where I'm gonna live, and if you don't give the answer to me today, that's okay. But just, you know, letting you know, something that I want some guidance on. Okay, what are the 3 most valuable lessons that I've learned? I'm reading from my phone if you see me looking away. The first one is that God always has a plan, but you can choose to be part of it or not. And I think there's this misconception that as long as you believe in Jesus, that you're part of his plan. But you can actually choose to make a lot of decisions that will take you out of God's plan. It's something that I recently experienced. I think I made a lot of decisions that I didn't use godly wisdom for, that weren't really in line with the things that I believed and the things that I read in the Bible. And it led me down kind of a destructive path. And I think that my divorce was just a telltale sign of bad decisions and living outside of God's plan. And there's danger when you're outside of it. But when you're inside of it, like the way I am now, things can be a lot better. And even when bad stuff comes, you're still protected by God's plan for your life. The second one is, there are second chances, but time wasted is time lost. I'm 31 right now, and I really do think that I'm being given a second chance to do things differently in this new stage of my life. But at the same time, I can't deny the time that's been lost, and that's just time that I won't get back. Just kind of keep that in mind as you're making decisions. You don't have to delay the good things in your life. And then the last one is kind of linked. It's never too late to start doing the right thing, especially apologizing and forgiving. It's never too late. If you've been doing something that you just don't feel good about, you know, and you're just like, I don't want to do this anymore, you can stop. You can stop and you can start doing the right thing. And if it has something to do, I say especially apologizing and forgiving, because maybe there's somebody that you haven't forgiven, so it's just been on your mind. You know, you can forgive today or you can apologize today. And I really do think that there is power in verbally apologizing and verbally telling someone that you forgive them instead of just doing it in your mind, because yeah, there's a peace that I think comes from verbalizing that stuff. So next one, this is from an anonymous source, but it says, what is it like having such a great dad? So it's awesome. It's awesome, and I think I appreciate it more now than I did when I was younger. He's like a magnet and people gravitate towards him. And I think that when I was younger, I was always trying to fight for my dad's attention and his time. Now as an adult, I really, really appreciate it. And I also understand the amount of people that actually really need his time and his energy. And I just try and help him in that pursuit now. So many people that need him, that's his purpose. So having him is awesome. It's a daily inspiration. Did it hurt when you fell from heaven, guys? Yes, it hurt. I'm just kidding. Do you plan to stay in Del Rio? Hey, like I said, I've been praying about it and I'm relying on God completely. But I will tell you that I'm in the process today of picking up my stuff from my storage unit. Think of it like this. God can easily give us all of the paints and all of the paintbrushes and all the supplies and say, okay, just go and paint this beautiful scenery. I don't know about you, but I've tried to just freehand some paint and it doesn't come out so nice. But I think that sometimes God wants to give us more of like a paint by number type of instruction, because he has an awesome finished product. And sometimes we don't have patience for the step one and then step two and then step three. But if you've ever done a paint by number, you know that the product is usually awesome. And so I think that's kind of what God is doing with me right now. He's doing a paint by number for all my life choices. And he's like, look, just do this one thing. Once you do it, don't worry. There's a step after that. And yes, I'll tell you. Yes, I'll be with you. No, I won't leave you. Just trust me, just paint this little circle red. And so that's what I'm doing. I'm picking up my stuff, and that's what I've been hearing from God, is like, bring your stuff home. Ooh, okay, so the last two questions are kind of fire questions. Do I plan on having children? Gosh, I feel like this question is coming up a lot lately. I had every intention about a year and a half ago of starting to try to have children, because I did want children. And things changed, and so my idea about having children changed. But I'm not against it. Currently 31, gonna be 32 in September. I can still have kids. I still have time. I love kids. I love my nephews, and you know, I see the joy that they bring into everyone's life. No, my battery died. we made it and I drove the trailer. So we're in Katy now and we're gonna be staying with Julissa and Abraham. Should be fun, probably go out to dinner, hang out, you know. We are moving tomorrow, so gonna just make the most of the time that I have with them and just enjoy. Clothes with me, and I was able to actually leave the things that I didn't want there, and they're gonna auction it off, so we're gonna have some lunch.
Thanks to me.
Yeah, thanks to my dad. He was like, ask if they do auctions here so you can just leave some of these pieces. So that's what we're doing. How is it? It's me and Georgie, and we are at my cousin's house, and we're gonna hang out with some people from church because we're having an early Easter egg hunt. So, anyway. Thank you, baby. It's Easter. It's not Easter yet, but it's almost Easter.